I found that, you know, we are preaching, but people are just looking at us like this. You see, when you say the Bible says this, no one writing, no scripture, and people are praying, oh God, oh God, oh God.
No,
there's nobody, if we found which scripture you know, nothing. You are still talking about the scripture of 10 years ago. But I'm surprised when you are still going to school. Big manuals. But I'm surprised on the Bible. And this Bible has been a one Bible. Since you started, I mean, sub A, until matric, you go, it has been a one Bible, but in that Bible you have got three verses. This shows that really you are defeated. Can you see, you have read, okay, the books of Shakespeare.
Shakespeare.
Look at history, look at geography. You went to university, you studied sociology, physiology. But the Bible is still the same. But you can't read it. You can't even find the scripture. Even when you wake up, you just kick your black eyes. Already, you are just, thank you, Lord. The Bible is
there.
How old are you now? How many scriptures? The Bible is like this. I just found that maybe we need to wake up. Think about it. Now, when you want to pass a course, you make sure that you read. You even catch the examiner. But on the Bible, if I ask you now, tell me about 10 scriptures you love. You'll find that these are common scriptures, for with God, nothing is impossible. I mean, you can't even go and find maybe 10 scriptures every day. I say, what is happening with our memories? Like when, the moment when you hold the Bible like this, you find yourself falling on top of it. But the moment you put it aside, you get magazine. You know everything. I see you do it like that. Maybe there's another film. You just know it. You know the time. You know everything about that film. But you can't even watch the film of Jesus. You can't even watch it. You don't even care. The Bible, you see it when you come to church.
Bible,
I've been observing Christians. I found, I mean, these people who are Muslim are better than us.
But the Muslim bar feet.
The Muslim, you find them opening Quran. They know everything. They know everything. But Christians, we have got a problem. Tell us about we have a problem. Like now, can you just tell somebody close to you five scripture you know? Just tell. Just tell somebody. You'll be surprised. Ah. In the church, what we are doing now, it's fire. Come out. Fire, come out. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about.
Eh?
You can't even pray by the scripture. That is why you find that even you pastors, when you want to preach now, you have to go to internet to find someone's message. Because you don't have a fellowship now with Jesus. Because if you have fellowship with Jesus, Bible will be your way. When you read Bible, you find revelation. In the church, what is happening now? The message is 5 minutes, 10 minutes. From there, prophecies everywhere. Prophecies. Now, after you get the prophecy now, you get the prophecy, you are looking for it to come to pass. It's not happening. You don't have the word.
Look, I want a lynch.
You don't have the word now.
I want a lynch.
If you can look at our churches, I mean, we blacks especially, our focus is not the Bible. Go to white churches. You find their scriptures, they know the Bible.
The Bible.
And many of them are even smoking there. But you people are believing too much in the power of God, which
we're
supposed to be knowing the Bible. It will collaborate and make you a conqueror. Look at your church, what is happening now? I've been looking, I say, I come and preach. Like now we've got classes on Tuesday. Yeah. Look how many people are coming to that
class.
You'll be surprised to find many people are waiting to be prayed for. There are things you'll never get by prayed for. You need the word of God. I'm sure how many of you are hearing me? Can you just tell your neighbor five scriptures? Say, tell me five scriptures you know. When you see your neighbor laughing, he doesn't know. The reason why he's laughing, he's telling you, no. He's pretending like he knows. He doesn't know. Let's get the word of God now. You people, when you come to church now, this year, have a book. Have a Bible. Leave these issues of tablets, phone, whatever. Don't record. Also, stop your phone. Close it up. Write scriptures. Open your Bible. Read. Go back to where you come from. You'll move forward. You'll grow. There's no more growing now. What is happening now? You are coming to listen. What you hear the best is a joke. If I talk about a joke here, you won't forget it. But the word of God, you don't know about it. So I thought I will warn you. Because our Christianity is shaky. We have got too much babies now. You know, babies all the time, they cry. We've got too much babies. I believe from today, you people here, when I'm preaching, I say, let's open what, write it down. You go home now. You need to say, thank you, Lord, for this word. Look here, sometimes God won't honor you because spiritually you are defeated. The scriptures are there to revive your soul. Now when you reach there, you pray. Thank you, Lord. What will happen to you? From there, now you start to grow. There are things that when I look at them, I say, this is not written in the Bible. People are doing it. So now, when you grow, when you are meditating that scripture, the scripture will bring pictures in your mind. You know, there will be a flash from the spirit. From the mind of the spirit. That will flash to the mind of your soul. And it will open your spiritual eyes to see. I'll say it again. There will be a revelation that will enter. Listen. Any revelation we speak here, it enters the mind of your soul. In the mind of your soul, the scripture paint pictures that will flash to your mind. And now from there, you'll be able to see visions. Whatever you are putting in your mind, it paints pictures. Now, the more the word of God, the word of God now will create images. Now you'll be able to see. Oh, I'm seeing this. And whatever you see will come to pass. God bless you.
Amen.